interpret these signals? Did I say something? No, but I'm sure you could have interpreted something through the signals. That's what body language is all about. Hey there, I'm Nancy Shah. I'm a trainer, public speaker, anchor, voiceover artist, and founder of Speaker Circle. We started this initiative to help people improve their public speaking skills. We conduct our interventions online, and you can also be part of it. All you need to do is fill up the Google form. You'll find the link in the description. Well, in today's video, I'm going to talk about few basic things regarding body language. What is it? How you can use it? And what are the aspects of body language? So let's get started. We can communicate a lot without using a single word. Has it ever happened with you that when you met your friend for the first time, through their face, you could interpret that he's not in a good mood? Or when your father came home, your mother told you, "Don't bother him today." How did they get that? Through their facial expression, through the eye contact, through the gesture, through the posture, through their body language. What is body language? Is it something like this? No. Body language is all about the non-verbal cues that we give while we talk. So it's not about words that you speak, but how you reflect your body along with the words that you speak. The next question is, how have we learned body language? Well, let me ask you something. Has anybody told you that this means money, or this means okay or good? Nobody had taught us. It's just that we have learned through observation. We have learned body language through observation. It depends on culture, our upbringing, and our surroundings. For example, in most of the European countries, this particular sign means okay. But when it comes to France, this means nothing or zero. Well, in another country like Japan, the same sign means money. Crazy, right? Well, our body language depends on the culture that we live in. In other cases, sometimes the body language passes on from generation to generation. For example, I have one of my friends in her family. Every female I have observed, they have a typical style of sitting in a chair and they follow the same. However, they are not aware of it, but that comes naturally to them. Case, we learn body language through our surroundings as well. The biggest example is any child. They adopt so quickly. Like if they have seen somebody doing something, next day they'll do the same. They learn by watching people. As somebody has said famously, people don't do what we ask them to do, people do what they see. Here that we all are comfortable with some types of body language and we are not comfortable with the other. For example, when you fold your hands, do you have your right hand up or your left hand up? Well, I have the left hand up, and if I do the reverse, I don't think I'll be able to do it for more than a few seconds. It doesn't suit me. Everybody has their own preferences on how they want to use their body language. According to one research done by Albert Mehrabian, he presented that our oral communication consists of three things: our words, our voice modulation, and our body language. Can you guess what would be the portion of body language out of it? Well, he indicated that words are only 7%. Other 38% are voice modulation, and rest 55% depends on our body language. Well, don't take this literally, as you can't just communicate everything without using words. Your words also matter. But in typical communication, when you're talking to people, your body language matters more than your words sometimes. The next question is, can we plan our body language? Well, the answer is yes and no. It's combination of both, as it completely depends upon you. Let me tell you my secret. What I do to have a great body language on stage. I plan it a little. So when I write my script or write my draft, I visualize myself along with it and imagine what sort of body language I want to have at that time when I speak those words. Of course, you can't plan and prepare for each and every word, but at least you can plan and prepare for the things that you want to highlight or the things that you want to stress upon. So let's say if I'm saying something specific and I want to use a specific gesture at that time, I imagine or I visualize myself doing that while I write my script. As a result, when I go on stage, it becomes very easy for me to implement and have the same body language at that time. Well, the next and the most important question is, what are the different aspects of body language? Well, it's all about different things. Your gestures, how you use your hands, your eye contact, your facial expressions, and a posture. Too many things, right? Don't you worry, because we are going to create videos on each of these aspects in detail in coming days, and you will get updates on our YouTube channel. So why don't you subscribe to our channel to not to miss out any updates from Speaker Circle.